This is a Minkowski diagram. Space is on the x-axis, time on the y-axis, and the scaling is such that light travels along a world line with a slope equal to 1. According to special relativity, the physical processes we observe do not change in frames moving relative to each other with constant velocity. That's the reason why we can enjoy a cup of tea on an airplane without noticing the immense velocity we're moving with. Imagine someone traveling on an airplane. From our point of view, it looks like a sloped world line. But from his point of view, he's not moving, so this line we just draw is his personal standing still world line. Since standing still results in a world line parallel to the time axis, this is his personal time axis. Let's denote it with t' to avoid confusion. What does his space axis look like? One could guess that the axis of a moving observer are just rotated a little bit. In our coordinate system, the light world line is the one where one tick of time corresponds to one tick of space. According to Einstein, this should also be true for the guy in the plane. So we mark somewhere on the t' axis and know that this distance is traveled by light in the spatial direction. There you go. The assumption that light travels with the speed of light in all frames led us to the conclusion that the axes for a moving observer in a Minkowski diagram are rotated towards each other. We can do the same with another person flying in opposite direction. So she starts here and we see her moving to the left. With the same arguments, we know that this is her personal time axis, call it t'. And we also know where her x'' axis will be. In her frame, light also travels with the speed of light, so here you go. Up until now, we measured units of time and space in ticks on the respective axis, but what about measuring stuff in seconds and meters? If we mark 1 meter on our x-axis, where do we have to put the mark on the primed x-axis? To investigate this, we need some math, but that's a topic for another video. That's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching and see you next week.